Hello folks, and welcome to the first video of 2021. This is going to be a beginner's guide on how I set up a city at the start of the game and why I think it's the best method to do so. And yeah, don't worry about this junction. This junction will be going. This is not of my design or anything. That will be going in like a future episode when we expand out this way, because that is just not safe. But for now, how to start a city. Well, first off, time. Do not build this road yet if you are not ready. If you build this road, you start the game effectively. You see here your money. You've got $70,000 or pounds, or we're going to call it pounds because that's my native currency. You've got £70,000 here to start building a city. As soon as you build that road, all the maintenance costs and everything kick in, and yeah, you get start getting charged basically. So if we're going to build a city, what you do is you put it on pause, and then when you lay a road, you incur no cost. Time is frozen. There's no maintenance charges because time is frozen, and we have officially started the game. Although I do encourage people just to have a quick scan of the area just to make sure we're going to be moving in the right direction. We're going to set up camp near this waterfront, and we're just going to have a look around. Now there is a train line over here and here, and a motorway coming here and that way, and just have a look visually at where you want to go. But for now, we are going to focus on this section here. First off, we're going to want to bring them in off this motorway junction. Now, you don't need anything fancy. You don't even need anything this fancy. All you need is some way to get them on and off the motorway. So here we go. We go that way and we go down to 10. Oh, sorry. That way down to 10. Then we bring in what I like to call a dual carriageway. And we come out and bend it round just to give it a bit more realism. Then we're going to come, delete this road, and we're going to put our on-ramp on as close to that as possible. We want them to slow down anyway, for safety. And on-ramp there, so you've got your off and your on. That looks pretty perfect to me. And now, I know we're not even like 5 minutes in and the British guy is building a roundabout, but you know, such is life. So we want to build a roundabout here. This is going to be the first one. We want a fairly big one, about 5 all the way around. Okay, now these strands are going to go off to different places. This strand here is going to go off to our industrial zone, and just to give it that British vibe, because there is no, not really a straight road. Well, there are straight roads in Britain, but like, just to give it that country-ish vibe, we're going to be bringing it around. It's a bit too curvy, but you know, it will do for now. We're just starting the game. We can go back for detailing later. And now this is going to be our industrial zone, and it's just going to be our temporary industrial zone. So this can be squares because it's not going to be there for very long. And oh, almost like I did it before. Well, here's our chance to put a curve in that road. That's gonna be too bad, isn't it? Back that up a little bit, and there we go. Perfect. Okay, so this is gonna be our industrial corridor. Quadrant? Yeah, quadrant. We'll stick with quadrant. And now, I am gonna cheat and put them. This is for the move it mod. I just wanna do a bit of good housekeeping and move all these trees. So we're gonna be moving all these trees. There we go. Wonderful. So yeah, the reason is just to save my CPU, because I don't know how big this is going to get, so we can always come back and put the trees in later. But for now, we're just going to take them out so they're out of the way. But if you're playing normally, yeah, that's fine to build one here. It's just a little pet peeve of mine. So now, this one is going to be our residential. Also going to come in at a funny angle. that. And we're going to build a tinier roundabout. We're just going to go up 3. And this is going to be the top of our high street. Get off the curve tool there, and we're going to come around here. Yeah, just along here. This is going to mark the bottom of the high street. But before we get too carried away with that, we need to put in power and water. So we've got our basic layout. We know roughly where everything's going to go. So I always start with a powerhouse factory, just because with a coal factory, because it's not clean or anything like that, but it does provide regular stable energy, and that's what you need at the beginning, just nice stable energy. And now for water, you've got the two for the inn. You've got this like water tower that I never use unless I'm doing like an American theme build, because those are very popular over there, or water power pump, which is the main thing I use. I wish they had something kind of like the sewer station but on land. That would be wonderful. So we've got our innards, and just to make sure to be careful, you've got these two options for sewage. You've got your inland sewage plant, you've got your river sewage plant. Now if you put your sewage river plant upstream of your water intake plant, then you know sewage is going to come out here, it's going to go in there. And if you put it too close downstream, sewage can flow upwards if there's too much of it, and then go into your pipe here. So if you haven't got the inland like sewer stream, I would recommend putting your sewage pipe at the bottom of your map where these down arrows are, so all the sewage goes down here and it's being cleaned out by all the fresh water coming in here, and your intake pipe is at the top here. So if you're noticing your citizens are randomly getting really badly sick at the beginning of your games, it's probably because you haven't put those in the correct places. So, piping. Now, I'm always one of these people who has very clean piping and just very clean, organized piping, because it's just, I just feel it's more efficient. And we don't want to come out too far. How far are we going? Way too far for the beginning stages. I'd say about that far. We want to try and keep this straight with that, so we're nice and in line. Come down about 90 degrees here. Now remember, we're only filling in this part of the map because we removed the trees. I know how far to go, but if you weren't, you could just judge it by these rocks up here. There we go. And come back there, nice and efficient. That is that section fully covered. So we've got piping, we've got our sewage intake, we just need our sewer outtake. Well, space already occupied by what? Okay, fine. Now you see this little blue circle in the center of the thing, that means if I place it there, it will be drummed into that pipe. Where if I place it over here, that blue circle disappears because it's not on the pipe. So if you want to save a little bit more money, you can do something like that. So it's already plumbed in and you don't have to spend any money on piping. Now this is going to ask for a connection to be to the pipe. You can also do the same thing with that, but meh. And also this they both require power, so no matter where you place them, they need power. So the sewage plant is fine, because that's right next to the power plant. However, the water mains here, they need power, so we're going to bring these over like that. Nice and simple. So we've got all our basics. We've got sewage being handled by that, we've got water being handled by that, and we've got power being handled by a power plant. And we've got over £20,000 left to play with. So, first thing we're going to do is to basically mark out our city. And we're going to swoop this in like that, because what we want is a road coming off. We're trying to make this a very British road. So this was the original road going into the town, or away from the town, I don't know, something like that, maybe. Then the roundabout connected them up. And let's bring in a road off here, make that nice and short, and then curve it. And we're going to want to build a kind of a riverfront for these people. So we're not going to go too close to the river, but we're not going to go shy away from it either. Not every road has to be curved. And then, because the pipes run out about there, so we're going to bring that round. Then that leads me nicely on to the next roundabout, which is going to be three out. Get the right tools. Come on. No, I didn't do it. How odd. Okay, we'll just do it by eye then. There we go. Back that up a little bit, and we're going to come out at a slight angle like that. Boom. Ooh, not liking that kink. So we're going to get the curve tool, get the road, come out to there, and then boom, nice curvy road. Okay, so we've got a little kink, and yeah, maybe there's a tree or a rock there and they just put the road around it. We can come up with many stories for our little village. And then we're going to have a road here that connects to the high street. Nice straight road. And then we're going to make it come off. Yeah, loving that. Also, I want to make dead ends, because dead ends are very common in this country. See, if you're struggling like that, you could just turn off all of these, go back old school, and get the perfect curve that you want. See, there we go. And we're going to have one that comes off here. Almost like they connected. Oh, we could connect them actually. Yeah, go for it. What does that look weird? That looks weird. Let's have that come down here. There we go. Wonderful. Alright, well, keep an eye on your money. So we've got £12,000 to go, so, and we're already doing all these decorations and stuff. There we go. Now we're going to leave a bit of a green there. Do need a bit more of a barrier between these two, actually. Thinking about it. Yeah, because they're going to get very sick. Right, we're going to move these down. We're going to move this down. All of this down. Last minute design quibble. So yeah, about here is where we want that, because then that allows enough room for all of this to do its thing. Turn all those back on, please. There we go. Perfect. We're still going to have this. This was the main road that came in. So that about there. If those things are annoying, you just push them back. What's going on there? Boom. Boom. Perfect. Okay, right, curve tool. I wonder if you'll work. Nope. Okay, we're gonna have to free ball this. No, I don't like that. We're gonna have to. Ah, oh, there we go. Even better. Even better in my eyes. The wonkier, the better. Okay, let's have a look at our water situation. Cool. We got still got 10 grand, even after all this fussing. Now, I will remember at this point, so we've got a, like we talked about the power situation going to the water, we need power going to the residential zone, so we'll pop one of these things right here, and then this is where we're going to encourage our village to grow. So this is the first road that came in. We're going to have that coming out like that. Is that looking? Yep, perfect. And we're going to have a road coming off here straight for the first bit. Oop. Game loves to toy with me. I'm gonna bring this over here like that. Just double check a war. Okay, so we've gone too far on that one. What about now? So that is perfect. No building beyond this. Feel we should have ones that come off this but don't actually connect to the main high street, just to give it a bit of realism, because not everything would connect to one another. And you remember, this is going to be a larger picture. We're going to come out here. We are going to connect these two up though.
At Sternberger,
I'm going to do it in the most pretty. Oh, that's lovely. I love that. Okay, so we've got a little town green down here, and yeah, loving that. Right, we got 4 grand and we've messed about tons. So, first things first is we are going to go to our budget and we are going to lower everything down. All of these go to 50%. There is no need to be spending that much in the beginning of your game. OK, Okay, so now we want to encourage people to come into this zone first so that our power is all hooked up. And there we go, we will start the game in just a sec. But before we do, just a quick check before we turn the engine on, and you've got to put your industrial in there. So this section down the middle is going to be commercial. This is going to be the high street. And then these two sections are going to be residential either side. So quick check, power, that's fine, and water is also fine. We shouldn't have any shock dramas or anything like that. So we are now going to turn on the engine and see if people want to move in. And they do, and they're moving in exactly where we want them to. So now they're in that section, we can now expand this area. So I want all this covered in residential. And then we're going to expand our things here, but we are going to make some room for, you know, the doctor's surgery and the, you know, the schools and things. So we're going to get to Little Hamlet today, and that is probably where I'm going to leave you and love you, and then we'll get to Tiny Town. I think Tiny Town's next. No, Village Worthy Village on the next one, and Tiny Town, depending on time. It's good to be back. I hope you guys are all having a great new year. Look at this. We are about to break even. Tons of people moving in. Just have a look at this demand and balance accordingly. If you need to top it up, just top it up a little bit. It's not such a bad problem with overcrowding at this stage. And yeah, you can see, look, so industrial traffic is going to come down here. Look at this long line of traffic. This is all going to be mostly coming down here, and you have your first divider, so industrial coming down here and residential commercial coming down here. And then when these guys want to go to work, they're going to take one of these back roads to go in and out of work, not affecting the traffic flow up here, which is why the system works. See, look, divided commercial and residential down here, industrial down here. Perfect. Tested and done. And the only mods we've used is to remove the trees just to give my CPU a little bit of a break. And you see, look, industrial come out straight away on there. And you'll find that the residential and commercial don't really use the highway interchange that much at this stage, because there's nowhere really for them to go. They want to go to the high street or to work. Well, the high street's there and work is there. Perfect. Now we're already turning £500 profit and still welcoming in new businesses and everything into the section. Oh, we're going to have to be doing some good old terraforming along here, aren't we? But yeah, as you can see, look, there's no panic. We're now making over 1,000, so we've doubled our income. Don't think we ever once went into debt, and look, we did all that time messing about making all these roads decorative. If we want, we can even start putting in residential on the other side. Anywhere with a power source that will come over. do not zone on a roundabout. It's very just no. Okay, so ta-da, we got small hamlet. Wonderful. This is probably going to be near the end of the video, just to show you what we're going to do now. We'll do these services, plug those in, and then we will come out of this. Okay, so people are demanding for electricity, but we've got that whopping great big power plant over here, so obviously it's our budget that's affecting it. So we ramp it up to about 65, we'll put it up 15%. It's a growing city, it needs it. And have a look, yep, well within our power needs. And yeah, perfect. Water consumption is still fine. We're going to plop those services in, aren't we? So we've got the doctor's surgery right here. We're going to plop that in on the high street so it can serve everyone. And what have we got? We've got the kids' school. I'm going to say we want the kids' school probably somewhere in a less crowded zone. I can't see this road being used very much, so why not just plop that down here next to the roundabout. The dump will go up here, and you've got to remember that we might want to continue this road, so we're going to push that over to one side. And also remember, you can't move this anymore. As soon as a little bit of trash gets in there, you have to empty it into a recycle center. Now look, we did all three, and we did all three without having to take a loan or anything. And another thing we can do at this stage, see, it's all intact, is to put up the taxes to 12%. But remember, they will want premium services if they're paying premium taxes. So boom, that should be solved. All good now. They want more industrial, that's not a problem. Because look, boom. And yes, we will change this over to farmland, because, you know, but that's one of the great challenges about this, is to eventually change everything over to greener pastures. And where you can't put a greener pasture in, move that over to like an area where, you know, goods can be made. But for now, I think that is pretty much perfect, and pretty much as the thumbnail that lured you into this video shows. And in the next one, we will be expanding out here and expanding up more into this way. Alright guys, have a wonderful day, whatever you're doing, and I will see you on the next one. Until then, goodbye. I hope you enjoyed that, and remember to like, subscribe, and maybe even hit that bell notification button so you don't miss out on the next episode. Oh, we've still got some seconds. Why not give me some feedback in the comments below? It would be greatly appreciated. And bonus, you can find me on your favourite social media platform. Links are in the description below. Until next time, have a lovely day.